Hey y'all, in this video we're going to do something just a little bit different. I'm going to try to show you how to get the most out of my YouTube channel. Now, a lot of people are going to say that this video is absolutely not necessary, that you've already follow me and have been subscribed for a while and you know all of this stuff. Please remember that new people discover my channel and new people get into the CNC hobby every day. And judging by the number of email questions I get on this subject, I felt that this was time to go ahead and make this video and reiterate a few things. So, what I've done is I've come to the video I posted last week, which was how to carve a tapered hole in V-Carve and Aspire. And you'll notice that I'm using Mozilla Firefox, and I am not signed in to my YouTube account. The reason for that is, if I was signed in, you wouldn't see a lot of the controls that I'm going to show you. So, you've come across one of my videos, you like it, and you want to know how to get the most out of this channel. Well, the first thing you need to do is click this subscribe button right here. Now, I can't click this subscribe button because I'll have to sign in to my YouTube account and it'll tell me I can't subscribe to my own channel. For you, however, your first step will be to click the subscribe button. The second step is a little bell button will appear off here to the right. Click on that bell to turn on notifications. Then come back and click it again. And a little menu will pop up with three choices: none, personalized, or all. If you click all notifications and set that bell, you'll receive a notification on your device, be it a computer or your mobile device, every time I post a video and every time I go live. That will keep you up to date on everything I post after you subscribe. But what about going back to find earlier videos that I've done? I reference the description box in just about every video, and I tell you that I've put a link to one thing or another in the description box below. This is the description box down here beneath my name. If you notice, my name is a link. If you click on that, it'll take you to my main channel page. We'll do that in a second. But right here, I have the title of the video, and I say there's more down here. Click Show More. So I click on Show More. There is a description to this video, an invitation to the live Q&A about this video, and a link to that live Q&A. Now, this link here goes to the Q&A we did on Sunday. I believe that was number 76. I may be mistaken there. Down here are a couple of ways of supporting the channel if you choose to. Here's some information on a podcast I do weekly with my partner in crime, Eloy Escajedo. And down here are three very important links. It's a link to the Vectric for Absolute Beginners playlist, 3D modeling for the Absolute Beginner playlist, and V-carving for the Absolute Beginner playlist. Let's go ahead and take a look at this playlist first. And what I do is I like to right-click and open link in new tab, because I'm going to be coming back to this tab. If we look at the playlist, the way I have it arranged is we start at part one, and every video in this series is linked right here on this playlist. Now, you can click play all over here, and it'll open up the first video, and if you have autoplay turned on, it will play all of these videos in order. Now, most folks are not going to have the time to do that, and I understand that. So instead, you can click on the video out here, and it will start to play that video. Then if you look over here, part two is coming up next. You can pause or stop a video at any time, but every video in this series is listed in order from 1 all the way to number 50, the last video in this series. So if I go back to the playlist and shut off picture in picture, thank you, Firefox. Every video in this series is right here in this playlist, and that's how you use the playlist. Now, you'll notice that some of these videos may be in more than one playlist if it's relevant to that playlist. For instance, Carving Open Vectors, Part 40, if we come back over here to my original page and go over to the V-Carving for the Absolute Beginner playlist, I'll right-click, open in new tab, and we see Part 40 is in that playlist because it's relevant to V-Carving. So you may see that in a few of these playlists, but that is the way to get the most out of this channel, is to take advantage of these playlists. Now, I said I would come back over here and go to my main channel page. You come from a video, come down to my name right here, click on my name, and that's a...
Hey, y'all. Mark.
That'll take you straight to my channel main page. From there, you'll see Home has this bar underneath it. You can click on Videos, and that'll give you a list of all of my videos that I've posted, starting with the most recent, which was Live Q&A 75, not 76. Also, we have playlists down here. Every video I have posted is in a playlist. Again, some videos are in more than one playlist. So if you get onto a specific subject, like using the distort tool, you can see that I have 3 videos over here on this side. There are 3 videos in that playlist. There are 6 videos in my two-sided machining playlist. Now, if you see this link here, View Full Playlist, click on that. That opens up this page with all of those videos linked and posted in order, from the earliest to the latest. I'll go back. All of my playlists are set up that way. So you can come over here to my home page through a video, then come over here to playlists and browse through whichever subject. If you're just learning to design a project, if you want to follow a specific project, if you are looking for a CNC video or a channel update video, or even want to go back to some of my live Q&A sessions, they're all on a playlist. Just know that some videos are on more than one playlist if it's relevant. Additionally, I have the Community tab over here. Community tab is kind of like a Facebook timeline in that I can come over here and post something that will appear in your subscription feed, but is not a video. I can create polls, which I have done. I can talk about things that have been going on the channel. I can post updates. I can post pictures. And I can re-recommend videos if I'm getting a lot of questions on them. I can post pictures and talk about an upcoming project. And, more importantly, you, if you're logged in, can comment on that post. You can ask me a question, give me a thumbs up, a thumbs down, whichever you prefer. And, of course, there's links to my store, links to channels that I'm subscribed to, and an about page that talks about me and my channel. So, that should help you kind of navigate the channel, show you how to get the best bang for your buck here, and maybe help guide you along in your journey in learning how to use the Vectric software. So I hope you got something out of this video, and if you did, I hope you'll give me a thumbs up. As usual, this afternoon at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, I'll be hosting a live Q&A session where you can ask me a question about anything that I've discussed in this video. That's this afternoon at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, right here on my YouTube channel. And it will be live Q&A number 76, for those of you who are keeping track. So I hope to see you this afternoon. And as always, whether you subscribe to my channel or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch, and y'all take care.